One of the questions we want to answer is which products have the highest profit margins. We can investigate that graphically by plotting the retail price against the wholesale price. I'll use Graph Builder to create the scatter plot, and I can launch that from the graph menu. The Graph Builder platform has a drag and drop interface with a control panel on the left side of the window. The control panel has a list of the columns in the data table, as well as controls for the elements in the graph. The main part of the Graph Builder window consists of drop zones that determine which data are plotted and how the data are grouped. The element type icons at the top of the window enable you to choose the type of graph, and you can apply more than one element at a time by holding the Shift key. To make a scatter plot of the products, I'll drag retail price into the Y drop zone and wholesale price into the X drop zone. You can see that most of the products have a fairly similar relationship between retail and wholesale price, but a subset of them has a much steeper slope. For these products, a relatively small increase in the wholesale price results in a relatively larger increase in the retail price compared to the rest of the products. In other words, these are products with higher profit margins. Before we drill down into these, I want to make a few modifications to the graph. I want to change the title of the graph to Retail versus Wholesale. To do that, I simply click on the title and enter the new one. In this case, I'll just delete the two instances of the word price. Jump automatically adds a smoother to a scatter plot of two continuous variables in Graph Builder. The smoother shows the general trend of the data, but if you don't want it displayed on the graph, you can either select the element type icon at the top or right-click in the graph and select Smoother, Remove. When I hover over a point in a scatter plot, the hover label displays the row number and the coordinates of the point. I can use one or more columns in the label role to display the column information rather than the row number. For example, it might be more useful to display the name of the product when I hover over a point. I'll use the View Associated Data icon to navigate back to the data table.